In this video, we'll discuss about marsupialation. This is another option of treating cyst. It is also called as decompression because we are relieving pressure, intracystic pressure, and cystotomy and PASH 1 operation. Right? So we have to write definition, principle, indications, and surgical procedure, advantages and disadvantages. It is named as marsupialation because we will create a pouch in the cystic cavity, right? Marsupials, you know the marsupials animals, they are mostly containing a pouch in the lower abdomen region so that young babies can be carried in that pouch. That is why the procedure is also same. We are preparing a pouch. We are converting cystic cavity into a pouch. That is why it is called as marsupialization, right? So definition is nothing but creating a window in the outer layer of the cyst wall. After that, we will evacuate the cystic contents, thereby decreasing the intracystic pressure. That is definition. Then coming to the principle, because we are decreasing the intracystic pressure, we have already discussed the mechanism behind the cyst growth is increased hydrostatic pressure, that is increased intracystic pressure. That is the main reason why the cyst grows. Because we are decreasing that, we are relieving that intracystic pressure. So once the intracystic pressure is relieved, bone grows from the peripheries. Bone grows from the, if you say in this case, so this is the cyst, so bone grows from the peripheries to fill that gap. That is the principle behind the marsupialization. Then coming to the indications. Indications, it is used in the cases of children, right? Children with erupting tooth or with incomplete formation of tooth. In those cases, you will go for marsupialization. As I told earlier, in every case where possible, we should consider enucleation as the first measure. If it is not possible, those cases are young children to avoid injury to the erupting tooth or to allow the eruption of the teeth. Complete enucleation may prevent the eruption of the enclosed teeth, that means teeth in that cystic region. To avoid that, to allow the eruption of the teeth, in children will go for marsupialization. And in case of large cyst, what happens in large cyst? If you do enucleation, then there may be the chances of pathological fracture. To avoid that, we will do the marsupialization. And vital structures, when the cyst is large in the mandible, it may involve or it may intimately related to the inferior alveolar nerve. To avoid the injury to the nerve, we will go for marsupialization. In case of maxilla, when the cyst is large, it will obviously in close contact to the maxillary sinus lining or nasal mucosal lining. When you do the enucleation in that case, it may result in the oronasal communication or oroantral fistula. To avoid that, we'll go for marsupialization. Again, in large cyst, which is associated with the root apices of many teeth, in those cases, if you go for enucleation, it may result in the pulpal necrosis because of the loss of vascularity to that teeth root apices, right? So in those cases, to avoid the pulpal necrosis also, we'll go for marsupialization. So these are the indications, only two indications. If you remember that, you can easily write children and extremely large cyst. Okay, after that, surgical procedure. So as I mentioned, this is the step-by-step procedure of marsupialization. First, you have to give the local anesthetic infiltration. You can do under LA or GA. Then soft tissue incision. You can see here, right? So this is the mandibular arch. This blue colored one is nothing but the large cyst. You can see here, in this cyst, the root apices of second molar, first molar and second premolar are involved. So in this case, if you go for enucleation, it will obviously lead to the, or there are high chances of pulpal necrosis of second molar, first molar and second premolar. That is why we are doing marsupialation. So incision, we have to take a semilunar incision in the buccal vestibule in the case of teeth present, right? When the patient is dentulous, avoiding or from a distance of 0.5 to 1 centimeter from the marginal gingiva, right? That means from this marginal gingiva, we have to avoid 0.5 to 1 centimeter below that. That means, say approximately this area. So in this area, we have to place a semilunar incision like this. In case of enucleation, we have given crevicular incisions around the neck of the tooth. But in case of marsupialation, we have to leave 0.5 to 1 centimeter distance here. And after that, we have to place a semilunar incision like this. Right? In some cases, when the cyst is located inferiorly, in those cases, you can go for inverted U-shaped incision also. Right? This is semilunar incision and another incision like this. You can place one more incision like this also. Right? But most commonly used one is this one. So after incising, you have to elevate the flap. So next step is mucoperiosteal flap elevation. Right? So we will see, this is the step-by-step diagram. This is the case of denticerous cyst in a young children, right? So this is the third molar involved, and this blue color one is nothing but the cystic lining attached to the cervical area of the tooth, right? And this black colored one is nothing but the bone. Due to the expansion of the cyst, we can see thinning of the cortical bone, right? This is the thinning of the cortical bone. And this red colored one is nothing but the overlying mucosa. Right? So, this is the denticerous cyst. We will see now. So, in this case, incision, in case of dentulous patient, incision is like this. In case of edentulous region, the incision must be placed on the alveolar ridge. So, in this case, we will place incision here. Okay? This is the incision. We'll place along the alveolar crest of the alveolar ridge. After incising, we have to elevate the mucoperiosteal flap along with the periosteum also. So, you have to do the subperiosteal dissection. You can see in this diagram. So, I have elevated complete mucoperiosteal flap. You can see, right? So, after elevating mucoperiosteal flap, we have to do bony window preparation. That means when the cyst is extremely large, in those cases you can already see the perforation of the cortical plate or cortical bone. In those cases you have to remove those small pieces and you have to enlarge the cavity. But in case of intact bone, you have to prepare a window in the bone. Right? You can see here, in this case, I can see the intact bone. But that is thinned out. You can see the intact bone. So, I have to prepare a window in that bone also. Right? So, next step is preparation of the bony window. We will remove this amount of the bone. Right? You can see here. This is the bone margin. So, bone in this region, I have already removed. After elevating the flap. So, once you remove the, or once you prepare the bony window, you can see the cyst wall or cyst lining. So, you have to make an incision in that cyst lining and we have to remove the superior aspect of the cyst wall, right? So, in this case, after removing bone, this blue colored one is nothing but the cyst wall. So, I have to remove superior aspect of the cyst wall like this. So, I will remove this amount of the cyst wall. And we are lifting or we are leaving this amount of the cyst wall. That means cyst wall or cyst lining is not completely removed. This is the main difference between marsupialization and enucleation. In enucleation, we are completely removing the cyst lining. In marsupialization, we are removing only superior aspect of the cyst lining. The deeper aspect of cyst lining is left out. Right? This is the main difference. So, after removing or preparation of window in the cyst lining, we can see the cystic contents, that is fluids or anything, right? So that fluid is completely evacuated. You have to maintain high suction drain. Okay, high pressure suction we have to maintain so that we can easily suck out that cystic fluids, right? So after evacuating contents, then we have to go for debridement. You have to completely remove any loose particles or loose tissue in that region, and we have to irrigate with the betadine or saline solution. After debridement, you have to pack. That means this complete cystic cavity is packed with the gauze. You can use half inch width of gauze so in this case you can see the packing. This black colored one is nothing but the pack, right? So first we have to pack in the floor of the cavity, right? In the floor of the cavity we have to first pack like this, okay? And after that you can pack the entire cavity in layers, right? You can see in this diagram. So this is the packing. So one more step here is to suture, right? That means this elevated mucosal tissue, mucosal flap. There are three options in this. First one is, this elevated mucosal flap can be excised. That means we can cut the tissue to maintain the patency of the cystic cavity. That means we have to maintain this opening, right? What we have made. So, first option is, we can cut out this mucosal flap and we can pack the tissue. And the second option is, this mucosal flap, we can turn it down to line the cystic cavity, right? You can see here, what we have showed here is nothing but this red colored mucosal flap is turned down into the cystic cavity, and after that we can place the packing. And the third option is, we can place the sutures at the margins. Right, we can suture this red colored flap with the blue colored cystic wall. That means cystic wall and flap are both are sutured at the margin of the opening. These are the three options what we can do with the mucosal flap. Right, so once you evacuate the contents, the principle behind the marsupialization comes here, because once the intracystic pressure is relieved, so there is bone ingrowth to fill this defect from the peripheries, right? You can see here, bone grows like this from the peripheries, okay? From the peripheries, there is bone ingrowth to fill that defect, right? That is the principle behind the marsupialization, right? So, in some cases, right, the only indication of plugging, the purpose of plugging is nothing but to maintain that cystic opening or patency of the opening, right? So this is indicated in cases of when the cyst is large but your opening is small. To avoid injury to the surrounding vital structure, you are preferring a small opening in case of a large cyst. Then you have to go for plugging. You can see in this diagram. So this plugging is done after 7 to 14 days. Once there is union between the mucosal tissue, that is mucosal flap and cyst wall, once that union is healed, then you can go for plugging. And another purpose of plugging is to prevent the food lodgement in that cystic area. So you have to maintain that cystic opening until it completely filled with the bone. It may take, in some cases it may take around 2 to 4 months. In children, it is somewhat less, right? But in case of older individuals, when there is slow ingrowth of the bone, in those cases it may take almost 4 months also. Okay, and you can maintain this plugging, right? You can do with the gutta-percha technique, gutta-percha initially, or after that some resilient materials also, you can prepare the plug. And you can use the acrylic also, acrylic plugging. And one important thing when you are plugging, you have to maintain some distance between the plug and the cyst wall. You can see here, this is the plug and this is the cyst wall. You have to maintain some distance to allow the ingrowth of the bone. If you completely or if you closely place the plug margin and the bone, so it may hinder or it may obstruct the ingrowth of the bone. Right? This is plugging, which is indicated in cases of large cyst, but you have prepared a small opening to avoid the injury to the adjacent important structures. So this is about plugging. Right? So this is the marsupialization technique, what we commonly do. And one more modification of the marsupialization is nothing but marsupialization into the maxillary sinus or into the nose. That is marsupialization by opening into the maxillary sinus or nose. The only indication of this modification is in cases of maxillary cyst. When the maxillary cyst is extremely large, so that it occupies almost half of the maxillary sinus. In those cases only, we'll do opening into the maxillary sinus or nose. You can see in this diagram, right? You can see in this diagram, this is the maxillary molar, and this red colored one is nothing but the flap, and black colored one is nothing but the bone, and this is the maxillary sinus, and this blue colored one is nothing but the cyst. Cyst almost involving more than half of the maxillary sinus, right? This blue colored one is the cyst. So this black colored one, this one is nothing but the displaced maxillary sinus. Usually maxillary sinus lining should be somewhat here. So this is the maxillary sinus original lining. But due to the enlargement of the cyst, this lining is displaced upwards. And the size of the maxillary sinus is decreased. So in this case, we'll make incision in the crevicular aspect. Right? This is slightly different from this one. Right? So we'll make incision in the crevicular aspect and elevate this flap. We'll completely elevate this red colored flap so that we will gain access to the bone. In bone, also you have to make an incision. We have to prepare a bony window in the bone to expose this cystic lining and the maxillary sinus. So, after elevating the flap and preparing a bony window in this region, it will be like this. After that, we'll remove some amount of the cystic lining also, right? And we will evacuate the cystic contents, right? After that, will remove the partition between the maxillary sinus and lining. That means if there is slight amount of bone in between the maxillary sinus or in between the cyst, in between the maxillary sinus and cyst, we'll remove that bone also and we'll make continuous cavity. That means cyst cavity and maxillary sinus cavity is joined, right? That means we'll join like this, right? We'll join this cyst like this with the maxillary sinus. And after that, now the procedure is over. After that, we'll replace this mucosal tissue and we'll suture here. Right? We are not removing any amount of the mucosal tissue here. We have removed only a bone to prepare a window. And the cyst cavity and maxillary sinus cavities are joined. And we will suture. After this, we'll prepare intranasal antrostomy, right? That means a opening is prepared into the nose by making a window in the inferior meatus like this, right? This is nothing but the intranasal antrostomy. By through this intranasal antrostomy, you can place the packing also. That what we have done here. We can place the packing in this complete cyst like this. Right? So this is the purpose of intranasal antrostomy. So this is marsupialization by opening into the maxillary sinus or nose. Right? This is one modification. The only indication is in cases of large maxillary cyst which occupies or which displaces more than half of the maxillary sinus. So this is the only indication. Right? Then after that, this is all about the surgical procedure. And after that, advantages. The advantage is, it is simple. It is a simple procedure when compared to the enucleation. Right? One advantage. And second advantage is, it avoids damages to the internal vital structures. Right? So, what are the indications of marsupialization comes in advantage? Right? It is allowing the tooth eruption. And it avoids the pathological fracture. And it avoids the injury to the vital structures like maxillary sinus lining or nasal mucosa or inferior alveolar nerve. In those cases only you are going for marsupialization. So those are the indications. Indications will become advantages. You can write them. So it is simple. Then coming to the disadvantages. The main disadvantage of marsupialization is pathological tissue is left behind. Or we are leaving some amount of the cystic lining, which may result in the recurrence of the cyst. This is most important disadvantage. So when complete cyst wall or cyst lining is not available, the histopathological examination is also difficult. And after that, slow healing of cavity. This is another most important disadvantage. This healing of the cavity will prolong until almost 2 to 4 months. There is slow healing of the cavity. Until that, you have to repeatedly pack the tissue, pack the cavity, and we have to repeatedly irrigate that cystic region. So there is lot of time taking procedure post-operatively, and it is also discomfort to the patient. Repeated appointments we should post, right? Then there is food lodgement also. If there is food lodgement in the cystic cavity. Right? So this is about disadvantages. This is all about marsupialization. And that plug is impregnated with the whitehead varnish. Or you can use like whitehead varnish contain benzoin or iodoform. Iodoform acts as antibacterial solution to prevent the infection of that region. Right? So this is all about the marsupialization. So two options are over. First one, enucleation, then marsupialization. And the third option is, in cases of large cyst, first we'll do the marsupialization. And after that, once the size of the cyst is decreased, we'll go for enucleation. That is called as Waldron's procedure. Waldron's procedure. Right? In this case, first we'll do marsupialization. After some period, when the size of the cyst is decreased, we'll go for enucleation. Right? That is why the procedure is given by Waldron. Other Waldron. So it is called as Waldron's procedure. Also called as PARS 2. PARS 2 operation. PARS 1 is nothing but only marsupialization. PARS 2 is marsupialization followed by the enucleation. Right? That is the third option for cyst management. And the fourth option is radical resection. There are two indications for this. When there is loss of large amount of the contour of the bone, or if there is multiple recurrence of the cyst, or if there is pathological fracture, pathological fracture, unlikely to heal. In those cases, we'll go for radical resection. That means, if you take in this case, this is the large cyst, right? So it is almost involving the lower border of the mandible. If you take, this is the lower border of the mandible, right? It is almost completely involved the lower border of the mandible. And if you, after doing enucleation, marsupilation repeatedly, again there is cyst recurrence. In those cases, you will go for resection. That means we will do the segmental resection. Complete this amount of the bone or this amount of the mandible is completely removed. That is called as radical resection. Right? In maxilla, you can go for different varieties of maxillectomy depending on the size of the cyst and depending on the recurrence. So, another option. Right? So, there are four options. Almost four options. One of the modification of marsupilation, or you can take three options. First one, enucleation, marsupilation, and one of the modification of the marsupilation is nothing but marsupilation followed by enucleation, Waldron's procedure, or the third variety is radical resection. These are the options for cyst management. So this is all about cyst management. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.